So it's not about that. It's about the title and being put on the person, I think. And I think that's where the question lingers. You know, people say it for many, many years. You know Booker T should have beat Triple H, you know, at WrestleMania. You know, it was a built-in story. You know, should it have happened? You know, perhaps it should have. You know, that's a question that, you know, that's going to be, we're going to wonder about forever. I know I will. And I say, should I have won it at that time opposed to when I did, you know, win, you know, when I won it as King Booker? I don't know. You know, me personally, I think the critics take a lot of, put a lot of weight into, you know, that happening. But me personally, honestly, you know, when it happened, you know, I'm gonna be happy if it happened for Kofi Kingston, and if Kofi get a championship match at WrestleMania, I'm gonna be pulling for him to win it, just because it haven't been a black person to win the WWE.
And he's put in so much
11 years,
work.
Man, 11 yeah. years. This guy's been grinding and grinding and grinding and grinding. Kofi Kingston has been a staple in the WWE for many, many years, and he's no different than Randy Orton, Daniel Bryan, or any other of those guys. The guy can work. He's a performer. He's talented. He could talk. He took something, you know, in the New Day that was definitely a sinking ship.
It was dead on arrival.
It was dead on arrival. And those guys, he took it and they made it whatever they wanted it to be. And the guy is a major star right now, not because of the company's push, but because of going out there and getting himself over. You know what I mean? The fans love Kofi Kingston. Should he win? If this match is to rise at WrestleMania, I don't know. But like I say, I'll be pulling for Kofi Kingston. I'll be the guy in his corner. You know, saying, man, you know, when I see Kofi Kingston, you know, I'm going to say, if he's in that match, I'm going to tell Kofi, hey, man, I'm pulling for you tonight. Whether he already know if he's going up or down, I'm still going to be pulling for him. And the thing is, the question has been posed. Let me drop some knowledge on people here real quick as far as black folks in professional wrestling. There haven't been a whole lot of us in this business to push to the moon. You know, let's count them on our, right now. Let's count them. Okay, Booker T, you know, back in WCW. You had Bobby Walker back in WCW. You had this one guy, his name was Craig the Pitbull Pittman, back in WCW.
Ron Simmons was in WCW for a while.
Championship material. Who else? As far as a black guy that you could really look at it and say, well, this guy here, man, he may have the, you know, what it takes to get to Ahmed Johnson.
Ahmed, Bobby when he first broke in, Bobby, right? But that's WWE, but...
Yeah, yeah.
JYD.
JYD, that's going way back. Big E Langston.
Big E.
Xavier.
Yeah.
You know, come on, let's keep naming them.
Ezekiel
Jackson.
Yeah, he was good.
He was another one. Who else? Who else we got? Come on. Help me out here. Come on, help me out. We got 30 years of I've been in the business 30 years.
And Godfather.
Godfather. There's another one. Okay.
Rock.
The Rock. I mean, I don't call The Rock black.
Yeah.
Okay.
He identifies more Samoan.
Like Tiger Woods being Kavlan Asian. All right. My thing is, we just sit here, you know, and try to pull out as many black wrestlers as we possibly could. And I've been in this for almost 30 years now, and we could not name 20 black wrestlers.
Stevie Ray.
Stevie Ray. Stevie Ray. We can't name 20 black wrestlers that's been, you know, on the card to be put in that position. And if he is on the card, should he be put in that position just because he's black? I don't agree with that. You know what I mean? I feel like, me personally, I got put in a position, you know, to win the titles because I was talent. You know, I thought I was a guy that was, you know, working at the top of the card, you know, and it was one of those things to where I had to write my own ticket.
Yeah, no, I completely understand that. And the thing is with Kofi is I think that it definitely, him being, you know, a black performer in a prominent role is a segment and a portion of why people want to see him at the top of the food chain right now and win that championship. But I also think it's just because of his ability. There's not a lot of guys, Book, when you think about it, who've been on the court as long as Kofi Kingston has and been able to sustain relevancy. A lot of the guys even you named, when you think about their runs on top or their runs on the card or their runs with WWE, they haven't been that long. You know, Godfather was there from, you know, as Papa Shango, late 80s until, you know, some of the 90s, or I mean, early 90s into the late 90s. You think of Ron Simmons was in WWE for a few years.
Did we say Mark Henry?
Mark Henry. We forgot Mark Henry. Yeah, Mark Henry's had a hell of a run with the company, but not a lot of guys have been able to sustain that long run and be relevant and not drop off at all in the fans' eyes. If anything, Kofi Kingston over the last 11-plus years has gotten better as a performer. If you saw him at that Elimination Chamber pay-per-view, the boy was good, man. He was the real boy there. And he had that whole crowd. Here's the thing. Working around reality wrestling, seen hundreds of wrestling matches.
Yep,
hundreds.
Yep.
I was sitting there with our director of our show, Kevin Bernhardt. He's probably seen thousands of wrestling matches.
Yeah.
We were sitting there in the stands at the Toyota Center, and Kofi Kingston had us kind of jumping out of our seat.
Let me tell you something. If anybody should, you know, get a shot, especially a guy he's proved himself. Kofi Kingston's a hell of a worker. Kofi Kingston is not the, you know, one thing I think the one thing that I think have held Kofi back just a little bit is because Kofi's not 6'3".
Right.
You know, Kofi,
he's not 220,
Kofi's not 225, 230, you know, and that right there, I think that's the one thing that have held Kofi back in the WWE, because he's always been looked at as kind of like a small guy, you know. Can he sustain being the world heavyweight champion? Now, I think things have shifted in his favor, because we got guys like Daniel Bryan. We got the smaller guys like AJ Styles. You know, so I think now it fits for him being champion more than it perhaps, you know, just say, for instance, 5, 6, 7 years ago. So hopefully Kofi Kingston will get that nod. Kofi will be the guy that, you know, be the heir apparent, you know, to me, because I've been looking for the next Booker T for a long time. I've been looking for the next, you know, African-American, you know, heavyweight champion or WWE champion in this business. And if anybody in this business is worthy of getting that nod, it's Kofi Kingston, okay? And I'm not just saying that because he's a brother or anything like that. I'm saying that because Kofi Kingston is talent, okay? I don't give a brothers the nod just because they brothers, just because they black, okay? I give Kofi Kingston the nod because he's a hella talented individual. Some of the stuff Kofi Kingston does defies the odds. The stuff Kofi Kingston go out there in the middle of that ring and do on a nightly basis, I could not do on my best night. I could not go out and top what Kofi Kingston can go out in the middle of that ring and do. Now, not saying that I wasn't great or anything like that. It's another story. I worked on another level. I always looked at things from a storybook perspective. Kofi Kingston is the ultimate specimen as far as an athlete go. And I give that young man props. I give that young man props for sticking around and weathering this storm, having to play the politic game, having to go out there and not, you know, having to, you know, win by attrition. And a lot of times, that's the way you got to win. Sometimes you got to, you know, not get hurt, not get injured, wait till somebody fall off, wait till the fans, you know, get behind me. It's so many variables that come into play when it comes to making it to that next level, becoming a champion in this business. I've been fortunate to have done it 35 times.
And 2 Hall of Fame inductions.
Yeah, I've been lucky. And hopefully Kofi Kingston will be just as lucky, if not sooner, at WrestleMania. He will get, you know, that grand prize, and that is the WWE champion. And all of this will be over. Back in a minute.